So, I made a video about how we should all play our gaming backlogs, and I still definitely stand by my point on that video. So many of us have these huge backlogs that are full of some games that could be some of our favorite games of all time. Yes, that includes me. My backlog is fucking massive, so I thought it'd be a good idea to make a series out of me playing games in my backlog. It also gives me an excuse to play these games because I'm always way too focused on making videos. So why not combine the two? I am a bloody genius. So here we are, fellas. Welcome to Conquering My Game Backlog. Let's begin. We're starting off with a pretty big game, and technically I have already finished the first Death Stranding. I thought it was fucking horrible, but I did go into the game with a pretty negative mindset. I can't blame myself though, to be honest, with how Kojima fans make the bloke out to be the second coming of Christ. Kind of annoying, because he's not. If you don't know already, Death Stranding is a walking simulator where you deliver packages, and my dumbass was expecting so much more in my original playthrough, because, you know, it's Kojima. Whoa. I thought about giving the game a second chance, and I saw the director's cut had an upgrade button for people who owned the original already, and it was only £6, so I thought, why not? And to be honest, I am actually enjoying the director's cut so far. I'm not enjoying it that much, but I don't hate it like the original. It's not even because of any changes. I think it's because I've gone in knowing what to expect this time. And I'm using this game as one of those games I can put on one of my monitors while I watch YouTube or a show or some shit, or even listen to some music on Spotify. It's quite relaxing. I also do really enjoy how the online is utilized, where you can see ladders and bridges that people have put down to help you travel through the world. I still fucking hate the BTs though. They are such a pace breaker, and I know they are kind of supposed to be there for that reason, but my god, they are fucking shit. I still don't like the story of the game at all. I find it so hard to care about any of these characters, and I don't know if it's because of ADHD or some shit, but all the cutscenes feel so dragged out and slow. In fact, there are 11 hours of cutscenes in the game. It got to a point near the end of the original where I started skipping them, but I want to try my absolute best to try and get invested in the story of the game this time. My fucking god, it's really hard. It's so fucking boring. Honestly though, who knows? I may end up loving the game in the future when I get much further into the director's cut, but we'll see. We will see. Learning to love Death Stranding. Future Proxodist upload, oh yeah. I've always found the Warhammer 40k universe really cool. In fact, I'm actually so excited for Warhammer 40k Darktides, the game being made by the fellas who made Vermintide 1 and 2, which are both bangers in on itself. But before Darktides comes out, I decided to check out Necromunda: Hired Gun, and holy shit, wow, the game completely nails the aesthetic of the 40k universe. You can tell it was made by people who are definitely passionate about it, and I mean, they're just clearly talented as fuck in general in terms of modeling. Just looking at some of these weapons gives me an aneurysm at the idea of the process of modeling and texturing and animating these bad boys. I mean, some of the weapons I've made, I fucking struggle with them, and they look like fucking Roblox guns, so I can't imagine how long these fucking took. The gunplay is absolutely meaty, as you would expect with weapons that look as chunky as this, and in general, it's one of those first-person shooters where you feel like you've snorted a load of cocaine, everything is going at a million miles per second, and all of this would be incredible if it wasn't so goddamn janky. Now, a bit of jank isn't too bad in games, but my god, it feels like there was just absolutely zero refinement put into the game. To be fair, I think it was made by a pretty smallish team, and with how good it looks, I doubt they had the time. Still though, it's ridiculously janky, from the takedown animations to the horrible UI, and even the movement and guns feel a bit janky too sometimes. Nothing beats how terrible the voice acting is though, my god. How many of you?
Go to hell! I'm in it.
Damn. Also, a lot of the enemies feel really fucking spongy. I really hate fighting these brute enemies. They fucking suck. Now, despite all of this though, I am having a good time playing this. Sure, it's jank a lot of the time, but when it works, It fucking works, let me tell you. And it's a good old time. Like a really fucking good time. I'm actually excited to play more of this. I mean, I'm kind of dreading the jank, but I'm excited to play more. I'm excited to see what the game has in store for me. Oh, there's also a loot system. I don't think they understand how loot systems work, and it's really fucking bad. Like, it's beyond terrible. Why is this even in the game? This one is a small one, but I've always had my eye on it. I just haven't played it until now. It's a game made by Hello Games, the fellas behind No Man's Sky, and it's a nice little game. It's nothing incredible, don't get me wrong, but it's a nice relaxing puzzle game with some nice exploration. You play as a little sock thing, and from what I've gathered, you go around reigniting the flames inside other sock fellas, which resurrects them. I think that's the plot. I'm gonna be honest, there's probably a deep meaning or some shit, but it all just goes over my head. Look at these little blue fellas! Some of these sock fellas are hidden around the world, and each one requires you to solve a puzzle in a little pocket dimension. Some of these puzzles stumped me, honestly. I am not good at puzzle games, okay? Don't judge me, I struggled with Portal 2. Not sure I have much else to say about this one. It's just a nice little indie game. I really like the atmosphere and just the general vibe of the game. It isn't a long game too, so that's a huge plus. It's always good when there's a short fucking indie game you can just blast through, you know? Really helps with playing backlog games. Okay, Wobble Dogs is fucking awesome. I've actually been streaming this one quite a bit because I didn't think I would enjoy it that much, but my god, it's hilarious. I was gifted it by my girlfriend because she was obsessed with the game, but I didn't get it from just looking at it originally because I just saw it as another one of those management style games, and I've always hated those style of games. Well, maybe that isn't the case anymore, because after playing Wobble Dogs, maybe I've just been playing some absolute shit ones, but this game is fucking great, that's all I'm trying to say. I'm enjoying this game a lot. The aim of the game is to just go against God and create some absolute abominations. That's horrifying! You do this by making your dogs mutate, and then when they've mutated enough, you breed them with another that has mutated in a completely different way. And, that kid usually comes out looking pretty funky. Oh, and the music that plays when you're breeding them. It's fucking awesome. Honestly, the entire soundtrack for the game is up there with some of the best. I love it so much. There's also quite a bit of customization, not for the dogs, but for the rooms they wobble around in. It's a lot of fun, and I can definitely see myself playing this more in the future, and I'll probably stream it a lot more. Well, there you have it. I have played some of the games in my backlog. Sure, it was only a few this time, and I've barely scraped the sheer amount in there, but hey, it's a start. Now it's your turn. Look at your backlog and play some of the games in there. Maybe comment down below what games you're playing that are in your backlog. Or maybe a game you finished recently. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like if you want to see more, because I would be quite interested in making this a series. It also gives me more reason to play my fucking backlog. I mean, fuck. Jesus Christ, there's so many in there.